it. Alright. Greetings. You know what? Maybe we should get the next last page up. What's our last page? 19. Alright, so we need. No, first, as always, we need to come over here, undo the paper, select the black. Right. Yeah, select the black, put the paper back, come over here, go to this, go to rectangle. Do. All right, so we need roughly about so. If I do need that, definitely this needs to be 30. But if I do that, because I wanted to do the eyes behind it, but if I do the eyes behind it, I would have to thrust him up here. So this needs to be smaller. Like so. And then, because I have it, and then it's inset inside of it. One big panel there. Started here. I hear you.
When we take on a mission, we must succeed or die.
I hear you.
Our style is unique and deadly.
When we take on a
and
mission,
no one we must wants succeed. To suffer
die.
The wrath our of the Ninja Empire.
Oh, Skip, thank you so very much for that resub, coming in at 24 months. You and I are the only ones really here in chat, so I will be the one to provide you with all the hype. Bam. Let's get these stream avatars going. All the hype. Bam. Turn this back down. But turn you back on. There you go. I don't exactly know why no one else is there. I'm assuming eventually it'll pop up. There we go. I'm assuming eventually it'll pop up. How's it going, Skip? He goes.
fair. How's your New Year's? How's it going? How are things? What? Ah. Okay. Oh, really? Can you tell? Can you share? Skulls from Nomad, then. Oh, really? Did it work out? Come on. Linky, you stupid thing. Oh. Okay. Let's check it out. Interesting. Nice. Okay. Cool. So is that how you're gonna do your stuff moving forward, or was it just an experiment that happened to work out to an extent? Okay. Went off this time, okay. See if I do what I want. Stuff like that. Okay. I was like, cool. So we're gonna try to see if we can make that work. Do we need to rasterize all of this? Might need to rasterize all of it. Because what I want. No, y'all need to come in too. Okay. The fact that doesn't allow me. Also, use my property and plugins. Oh, okay. Okay. See, what I'm starting to realize is that what I'm starting to realize is that you guys can really like sell almost everything, right? Like, oh, I did this here, this will help you, your STL file, or you can do this or you can do that. Figure something out. So in the sense of figuring something out, so I went to try and set up the KDL, the Kindle print on demand thing from Amazon, and after putting everything on, I was like, oh, the printing cost is less than what I do with my own thing. Like, okay, that'll be cool, right? So it'll be interesting to order from them. Excuse me. But when it was like, this is how much money he'll make, do you know that if you use their service, they get 60% of what you're charging? I was like, 60%? That's a lot. But it is Amazon, right? So, like, I know, I have it now as a safe draft because I was like, But I'm going, well, I don't have to house anything. I don't have to print it, right? I don't have to print it, ship it to myself, house it, and then ship it out to them. That's all taken care of from Amazon, and it's Amazon, right? So if anyone is like, I'm looking for character design, because one of my hashtags was character design. So if they're looking for character design, they're looking through stuff, and then my workbook pops up, and it's like, oh, right? It might actually reach a whole lot more people than I'll ever be able to reach. And so, while yes, I'm getting peanuts, but if I get a lot of peanuts, then it becomes like a full meal. You know what I mean? So it's really, really weird. What's up, Power Ranger? A Ranger X. That's what we're gonna go with. How's it going? We were just talking about how Amazon, like I have a digital product that I just released, and I try to put it on Amazon, and I found out that they take, after shipping, they take 60% of the money, and I was like, but then it was like, well, I'm not a bot. I didn't think you were a bot. A Ranger X. I didn't think you were a bot. That's funny. But yeah, we're talking about whether or not it's actually worth it to take such a massive hit as far as profit goes for the sheer sake of volume, right? Because it is Amazon and they do the suggestions and stuff like that. Like, is it worth it? You know what I mean? It's just like, you know? That's part of my problem, because the new job, I'm not really super worried about growing my reach. I only really care about the sense of professional development and tenure. Right. And see, because I've come to the point where I'm at right now, right? They're like, my school's like, we have it, but we don't really, once you hit a certain amount, like, once you hit 8 years, right, you go up for professor, and then that locks in your tenure. And so I'm like, okay, well, I don't really need to do anything because I'm doing all the stuff. So it's like, who cares? You know, so I'm just like, but I'm really looking to grow the brand and the IP now. So now it's like, well, is it worth it? You know, like, is it worth that? And I'm thinking about putting, because you can always take it back down, right? But I think the biggest thing for me is that I don't have any, like, overhead. I don't have any, nothing, right? I already created the book, and I'm just going to put it up on Amazon. And then Amazon, not necessarily is going to do anything. Like, I would still promote it, but it's like, hey, you know, here's this, and I did that, and it's on, you know, hey, it's on Amazon, go check this out. And if anyone ever would come up and be like, I want 20 copies, like, currently I have 5 copies of each one. And so if someone randomly gets a hold of it and goes, I need 20 copies, and I'm like, oh, poop, right? Like, I gotta order that first, then I gotta throw it out there. You know, it's just, it's crazy. You know, and so this way, I'm like, oh, go to Amazon, just pick it up from Amazon. I can have the books myself when I go to conventions and stuff like that, and that's where I can make a little bit extra money. But as far as the mass quantity goes, it's probably way better to take that 60% hit until something else, right? Like, if all of a sudden there's a publisher and then they want to house it in their warehouse and do all that kind of stuff, then it's like, cool, great. But if not, what's, you know, seems like this might be the way to go. But I wanted to sit on it first. You know, I didn't want to actually be like, you know? It was like, hard to grow besides hitting rock bottom isn't really well. Yeah, that's true. Very true. I don't do a how to draw series. Because, and this is going to go out in my Life of Kaiser, which I filmed this morning. I just got to edit it and put it out there. But the thing is that I do tutorials all day at work, right? So when I'm at work, that's what I do. I do tutorials. And I don't want to have to come home on my free time and then do tutorials, right? Like, I'm not feeling that whatsoever. And I'm like, so many people have asked for, like, tutorials and stuff like that, but I'm just like, I don't necessarily want to do tutorials, if that makes sense. Like, does that make sense? Like, everyone seems to be thinking that I'm crazy when I say that, but I'm just like, I just don't want to do tutorials, you know? And I love education, and I love what I'm doing as far as the art education side of things, and I really want to be able to do something, like, different, like art education. And that's why I created the workbooks, right? And I'm going to be doing that a little bit. So I'm going to be doing these workbooks. My next one is an actual character design workbook, not just this template. Hey.
Got you water.
Thank you. I closed it because
we're loud.
The TV echoes up the hallway.
I know.
But yeah, I did templates, and so now I'm going to be doing an actual character design workbook, which I'm super excited about, super duper excited about. But, you know, I don't know. Let's see, it does, I kind of do, but the idea of being able to do properly rather than improvising is blah. Well, and that's another thing, like, people have told me, like, if someone hits me right now and be like, hey, can you, you know, how do you do this? Like, I'll scribble it up, you know, and I'll draw it and be like, hey, so, you know, you can do this here. And that's just natural for me, right? And be like, fine. But if I had to, like you said, like, if I have to come in and script it and be like, all right, so this is how we do this, and this is how, I'm like, there are hundreds of that, right? There are people out there all the time, and I'm like, I don't want to do that. Like, that's, what fun is that, right? But I'd rather come with something different, right? Like, I'm doing the is it worth it. So I know that there are plenty of like product review things, but I'm like, that's something that I can do because it's an honest review. Like, I pick them up from the store and I'm like, this will be pretty cool, or this is really garbage, you know, and I tell you the honest to goodness truth, which, by the way, right now just dropped 1 minute ago. Just have a the next is it worth it, so boom, go check that out. It's on the new and improved Sticky Bones, right? This bad boy right here. They actually sent me one to review. Love it. Anyway, but that review is up. Went up 2 minutes ago. What's your goal as an artist now that you are established? As an artist, I want to do my own thing, right? And that's why I'm doing Ninja Empire. And what's funny is I started stressing about how it was looking, because I went back to Western comics, right? I went back to Western comics, and Western comics is not what I used as reference when I started making it. I went to manga, right? And how their structures and stuff is. And so I'm like, and I went back and I started doubting what I was doing. I was like, man, I gotta redo this. This isn't gonna work the way I want it to, and blah, blah, blah. And then I'm like, nope, this is your thing. You do what you want. And then, you know, issue two, if you're like, hey, that really didn't work the way I wanted it to, we'll do another one. You know what I mean? And so I can change it and work and do however I want. That's really what I want to do as an artist, right? As an artist, I want to be able to do my own thing, make my own mistakes, come back and be like, oh yeah, no, that failed miserably. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, and then do something different, right? And be like, oh, I'm going to try that, right? And we'll be like, yeah, let's do this. So yeah, that's my big goal. Not to mention, like, for the next issue. So let me see if I can show you something. I want to show you all something. And most of you have already seen it, but show you an example of what I'm thinking about for, like, issue one, because this is what I'm working on right now, is issue zero, right? All right. Oops. So, for instance, you know, like, right now, I'm doing this this kind of style where it's the paper and it's kind of on top of the paper and stuff like that. And that's, hey, Miss Ebony. And that's where we're going, right? The colors are all flat because it was like, oh, I'm trying to replicate the idea of the paintings that happened in Japan, right? In ancient Japan. And they were all flat colors on textured paper. And so I was like, oh, okay, I'll do this with faded colors and stuff like that. So that's kind of what I'm looking at right now. And I was like, this would be really cool. But the thing that I've done in the past, right? I would do things like this, right? And so it's full on, like, cartoon animated style, right? And I'm like, you know what? I wonder if I came in and did, like, a big poll and did both styles for, like, issue one, right? Like, that would be my big Kickstarter thing. It's like, hey, if we get to X amount of money, I'll come in and color these as this animated style. And then, you know, I was like, I'll render it out with this animated style. And then after it's out, I can literally have, like, a poll and be like, which one would you rather see? Like, how would you, you know, rather go about this? Because I like this, right? But this is kind of, it has its own feel, right? There's something to this. There's something about this that makes it different. Like, I like this. And if I was to ever go into an animated cartoon or anything like that, this is what I would do, right? Because I think that style fits. When I'm doing these character designs and all that stuff, this is what I'm gonna do. But this is the style, right? Like this, as you can see here in this page. So that's the best part about doing all this, is I can do whatever I want, figure it out as I go around, as I go along. Okay. Sorry, I was talking a lot. Now I'm gonna go catch up on chat. Okay. Because there's a lot of people who do tutorials that are more demo than tutorial. And a lot of that is because they're not structured properly. Yeah. Doing it in a way that's actually helpful is a lot more work. Exactly. Steve Bones is so good. I love them. I'm going to really start using them. I started posing them to take pictures and stuff just for reference. And actually, oh, that's what I'm going to do. Oh, sweet. So I was really trying to figure out what kind of artistic thing I wanted to do with my sketchbooks and then present on Follow the Kaiser, which is like more of a, hey, I want to draw, you know, like help, let's draw together. And I was worried about taking pictures offline and all that stuff. And so I was like, looking at it now, I'm like, ooh, I can take these pictures. I can take pictures of Sticky Bones and then draw those, and we can draw them together like 3-4 different poses and stuff like that. Oh, sweet. I love the Sticky Bones. They're nice. Okay, where were we? Sticky Bones. Well, nice. Funny enough, part of them was behind that I linked you earlier. Okay, they did a sculpture of the character last time here. Style of the original design. Okay, check where most of your viewers are. If the majority is outside the U.S. and Five Below is mute because Five Below is only in the U.S. by the way. But most of my viewers are in the U.S., the United States of America. At least that's what my analytics are telling me. They're in America. And I'm not just doing Is It Worth It for Five Below. I mean, I know that the last four were there. That's because they had just dropped that brand new release of how they were packaging everything. And I still have a couple things, but now I'm going to be doing other materials so that it doesn't just seem like it's a Five Below Is It Worth It channel. So I'm going to switch those up now. But it was mostly just for the holiday season, because what makes that cool was I also did another video of five gifts to give people for under like $20. Alright. Get that. This time I wanted to do her in my own style, and I liked it so much more. Yep. Face white eye. Oh, these look awesome. Like the dark monk with blue effects. The pose is impressive. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Like, I like it, right? Like, I love that. Just, they're gonna be fun. It's fun. But one thing that I was talking about in my Life of Kaiser video, which is gonna be coming out hopefully tomorrow, or possibly Friday. Probably gonna push it towards Friday just to make sure I have enough time to edit. But the one thing that I talk about in there is this comic, right? Like, I want to finish this, but, you know, I've talked about it before that I want to do world building. Like, I really want to push world building instead of like, oh, let's draw the comic. I'm gonna do that still. Like, I want to be able to have the first issue 1, like by the end of the year. Like, that I really want to be able to have like 2 issues by the end of the year. So this graphic novel, and then we're gonna go to 22 page comics. But the majority of what I want to do is focus on developing the world of the Ninja Empire so that I can make my role-playing game, right? Like, I already technically have the rights back to my game mechanics and everything, and so I want to be able to make the RPCG, the role-playing trading card game that I developed, and make it what it actually is supposed to be, but with the world of Ninja Empire. So I think that should be a lot of fun. So that's what I'm going to be focusing on as soon as I get this done. That's what's happening. Oops. Everything is going to be we're gonna do some world building. Really looking forward to it. Really, really looking forward to it. Okay. So, since we didn't get together Wednesday because family stuff, how are you guys doing? How was your New Year's celebration? You guys do anything fun? Miss Ebony, did you get all your whatchamacallits in? Or all your gifts in? Mostly quiet. Yeah. Girling. Yeah, I have to do that too. I figured I'd probably do that tomorrow. I've transferred all my classes over, so we're pretty good there. Oops. There we go. Happy New Year's. Oh, what happened? What happened, X? What's going on? You did not have a good start to your new year? Bad stuff. Oh man, I'm sorry to hear that. I'm so sorry. Hopefully everything gets better for you. Hopefully 2024 will be better for you then. If 2023 was poops, hopefully this year will be better. That I know is in here. Then I'm gonna have to draw all these poses. here we go. Missed it. Went the wrong way. Miss Simony didn't want to answer me about her gifts. I understand. Make my day. All right, that's cool. Good. So X, what's up, Mandala? Are you an artist? Happy New Year, Mandala. How's it going? How are you? How was your New Year's? Oh, wow. Already? That's sad. What happened? I know it's in here somewhere. Good one. So, got full character image. Full sprites. Oh, okay. I understand that. Done. Yep. Yeah, the figuring out how to do the goals, that's the hard one, right? It's real easy to come up with ideas of what you want to do, you know? The spreadsheet. Cool. So you do sprites. That's cool. What kind of game was it? Fantasy, sci-fi? What were you trying to do for an old engine? Yeah, that's what they say. They say it's fun. The journey. Punches, jumping. Ooh, nice drop kick. Punches, explosions, kicks to the face. So you say you were working on this game, and is it your game or is it someone else's game? Because if it's your game, you should keep going. Because what I've realized is attraction comes with consistency, which sucks. You just gotta keep posting. Okay. So. Not that one. It's either that one or where is it? I guess let's do this one. It's not my characters. Oh, okay. Okay. Get a new one. Share these holidays. There was a fighting game engine. Oh, nice. Character fully coded. Oh, nice. Do you want to drop a link so we all can see it? See the characters that you did? Would love to see it. We share these holidays. Yay! I have him come like this, so he would have to be here to make sure that that leads us in. Are 7 igloos. Still runs on steam power. We discovered it's like now we discovered electricity. Thank goodness he decided to share that with us. people are looking. X, Ranger X, I was asking if you wanted to throw in a link because I'm also streaming to Twitch. And so if you put the link in there, the people over at Twitch can see it and then they can click on it and see. All you have to do is copy the link to your video and then just paste it in the comments and then it'll shoot it over to Twitch as well. I won. New Year's win. Yes. Same old rigging. Yep. What? By the way, Rumble gives ads right away. Also seems not safe for work. The emoji so far? What, with the Battle Royale? Oh. I've never heard of Rumble. Hey, Whimsy, how's it going? It's been so long. So, I have to drive home? Yes. Rumble doesn't have the best rep. Nah, okay. That's good. Was the drive bad? Actually like Rumble, not that bad. Rich right now. All the basics, since YouTube's got some censoring going on. That's true. North and west were a mess, lots of accent. He's green on there. In pure cheap cosplay. Interesting. Rumble. Yeah. I can't necessarily say that I have a problem. here. Yeah, whatever. Here, that'll come down a little bit lower. It'll be hard to search on there. Dr. Bird. Okay. Hard to search on YouTube is what you're saying, right? He's a chiropractor. The knowledge doc. The knowledge chiropractor. He's there, blah 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 blah. He's there and he's yelling. Don't test me. And he's like, oh, whatever, man. It's not that big a deal. Where do I put her, though? I'm supposed to be doing next week. Oh, really? That's interesting. You used to be starting to show them first. Eh. I mean, yeah, algorithms and things. Just yelling at her. Do we put her here? Kind of in the background? See your year ago, so there were a lot of people whining about it. Not a lot of people. Yeah, it's people are, you know, people always are gonna whine about something. Okay, we can put her. That way we don't lose her. Right, so she would be here. It's like, oh, what are you doing? Like, blah, 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 blah. It's not that big a deal, boss. Yeah, who knows? But we'll, I mean, I guess time will tell. What did I put in the background? Did I put anything in the background? I don't think I put anything in the background. Let's check the comic, shall we? Okay, so it started here. Nope, nothing in the background. Nothing in the background. Okay. See, I think this table, because they would have gotten up. They would have gotten up. Maybe we need to put a chair. Because 22 of YouTube or any site explains it, people will start gaming. Yeah, for them to come up with a new. Yeah, yeah, no, absolutely. Assistant with previous pages, yeah. And I'm thinking, because I'm like, you know what? He has a lot to say here. There's a lot to say here, so I don't think I might put. Might be able to put a chair to kind of indication of the chair that they were sitting on because they had gotten up right there just in case. Or maybe we put the indication of the chair over here in this corner because he is not saying anything. So we put that chair here. Yeah, that way that could stay. We can stay consistent with that. Ooh. Why not keep the last page? Well, this is the last page. This one right here. Oops, not that. What is, what? No, not that one. This one. This one is the one that I have right here. That is the last page. But I didn't have I didn't know if I put anything in the bag, if I've established what this room actually looks like, and I haven't. So that makes life a lot easier. So it looks like we're good. It looks like we're good. So now we're gonna go ahead and save this as page. No. I did it again. Okay, so we need. We need to come here, and we need to get that out of there. We need to go to Ninja Empire comic, and then page 20. Page 20. Kind of hate the lessons the internet took from was background deets and scripts. What do you mean? What was that? Alan Moore does a lot, you know, Mr. Tree Man. All right, so then since I saved that, we need to open that. What? Where'd he go? Go up there. Oh, because it's got space. There we go. Open page 20. Okay, so go to page 20, we need to go back to the blank page, and then we need to go all the way back up here, control S, and then close out. All right, here we are. Back to here. What's this? What's this? New page. Then we're gonna drop this down. Oh, well, once you're on elite viewership, that's where I see the stuff. I mean, I still don't get Mr. Beast's YouTube numbers. People like him. It's a nice guy, apparently. Here we go. Yeah. Yes. And how much to add? Oh my goodness, that's disgusting. Nowadays, a lot of indie friends will fill up every panel with background deeds because they think they have to in the mainstream consistency. Yeah. Oh, that's true. Watchmen was great. Not every panel needs details. This is very true. This is very, very true. Sorry, well, your channel viewers follow. Oh, look, hi, how are you doing? Yeah, I don't think I want to, thank you. You gotta be careful. Miss Ebony might hit you with the ban hammer. Don't work on it as a craft. Maybe. But, I mean, I have to agree, though. I don't think you do not need to have every panel with a gazillion details in it. I mean, I'm a big proponent of that. Like, I'm trying not to do a lot. Oh, yeah, that's fair. I mean, I can see that. Miss Ebony, are you there? Yeah, I agree with you too. I agree. Yep. Let's see, so definitely just a little bit smaller, I think.
Illustrious. Yep. Oh, thank you. What are you doing? Squishy Bex. What's up, Bexy? Hydrate, we say. Okay. Right. Oh, the drawing more than once thing. Is definitely on my list of things to do is to draw my characters more. Hey Bex, Happy New Year. I'm drawing part of it. So one of those, yep. And then we draw more. Think about everything differently. Yep. So if I wanted to bring in first we're gonna come in on top of this, and we're gonna come in and go. No! Chinese food. Yeah, sometimes that's true. Depends on what you get from Chinese, you know?
contract by 5, sure. Is that enough? That's not enough. Contract by 10. How about, we'll go 15. There we go. And that'll be enough. All right, so now that we have that, we have to down here, drop the opacity a little bit, come to that one, and erase that. Oops. Oh no! Fire, driven by razor sharp determination.
We must succeed or die. Our style is unique and deadly, and no one wants to suffer the wrath of the Ninja Empire.
Undead, thank you so very much for that subscription. 22 months, my goodness. Thank you so very much. Can we please get some hype up in the chat? Hype, hype, hype. How you doing, Undead? What's going on? There you go. Some Happy New Year stars. Man, Undead came in, dropped the sub, and then went lurk mode. I was just like, I'm done, I'm silent. So I think that this one can go away. Whoops, that can go away. stay. Alright. Bam. It's like, oh dear. All right, so now let's come in. You guys have gotten quiet on me. Thank you. one, two, three. 22 ones. Three kids in that time span. Could have. This leg in a little bit more. No. Maybe not that much. We might as well get him in there. Ouch. Crackling all over the place. So, so. AJ, what's going on, man? Happy New Year. Need to post it. Okay. What do you have in store for us this month? Wednesday's pretty good. Today's been pretty good so far. That would be here, so we'll pop that over like so. Can't complain. Shoulder. So that would be here. I've been reaching out to them, trying to get them to. They had come to me, like a representative had come to me a while ago at a convention and was like, oh, you know, you need to come through and, you know, be part of our education thing. And I was like, all right, that sounds great. And they're like, email this place and we'll get to you. And I'm like, all right. So I did that, and then nothing. And then I thought I was going to go with someone, and then they're like, nah, not going this year. I'm like, ugh. So I keep missing it. Because I wanted to try it out. I wanted to try their Artist Alley out. But apparently it's almost impossible to get into. So I figured the only way I could get in was, you know, that way. So I was hopeful, but didn't work out. At least not this time, but it's all good. So do you have a table at MAGFest, or are you just going as a fan? That's fair. Here. It's way better. Mm-hmm. same. Gosh, I love digital is so nice. You just come in and fix stuff as you go. I'm like, yeah, that doesn't look right. Good stuff, good stuff. This one's, oh yeah? Oh, who's your guess? Or has it not been announced yet? Okay, nice. A little bit. Next here. For sure. Comes out, and we've got that happens. Then this would come over that leg, like so. My son is watching the crap out of that right now. So that's cool. Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm cold.
Cold?
It's freezing in here. Goodness.
Sorry. I didn't... didn't notice. Because I'm kind of bundled up. And you made me tea. Okay, so now that we have that, come in and we drop that again. Oops, no, not that one. Everything okay? All these extra panel page things here. Driving me crazy. And so we want to keep that separate. Okay. Alright. Convention itinerary. Currently I'm going to ChromaCon in Baltimore, March 1st through the 3rd, then AwesomeCon, March 8th through the 10th, AnnapolisCon, April 6th, Southern Maryland, sometime, I don't know, they haven't announced the dates for that yet, Ocean City Comic-Con, December 14th and 15th, and I'm still trying to get into, like I tried to get into Emerald City, they told me no, I'm still trying to get into a couple, so we'll see what happens. And I'm thinking about going to Nickel City Comic Con. Since, you know, San Diego cut me off, I don't have a lot of, What just happened? Me on blue. What the heck? What did I do? One blue. No, it's on a channel. Where are my channels? Still on blue. I don't want to be on blue. Okay. Now we should be able to do something. So, ultimately, I'm still trying to figure out what I'm going to do. Because not going to San Diego is really... it's kind of forced me to come to the East Coast, so... So I'm looking at a lot of East Coast conventions. Also, I was suggested to go to South Africa Con. I have a friend staying with us, and they happen to live in South Africa. So I reached out to them to see if there's anything we could do. Wondering why that wasn't working.
I'm back.
Hi. Welcome back.
How's your stream going?
Good. To work anymore. Vacation broke me. I understand that completely. I like your new tone, your new notification.
He's funny.
Yeah. No, he said NickelCon, Nickel City Con. That's the one that I've been suggested to go to.
Your headphones down, sorry.
All right, it's all right.
This feels good.
Did we ever go to Motor City?
No.
I don't know why it sounded familiar.
You can answer most of these questions pretty easily just by finding out what city they're in.
That's true. Is that a convention you'd go to? Mandala?
His answer should be the same as mine.
What?
I said his answer should be the same as mine. Go to any convention if I got to sit next to you.
There we go. Oh, Miss Ebony's back.
Miss Ebony.
Toronto Comic Con and C2E2. I haven't been to C2E2 in a long time. Skip with the win. No cheats, obviously. Obviously.
Is that your music?
Yeah. Much. Oh. works. Coming up on the last trace minutos. Just a little bit. Saving 70 hit us with the time's up. So, look at how far we got. I mean, we got the page laid out. Still gonna fix a little anatomy issue. I don't like the way that leg looks, so we'll fix that later. But already moving on to the inking stage, so that's pretty good. And it's a pretty good day. So, thank you all so very much for coming and hanging out on the first stream. What's the buzz? What's going on, DC? The buzz is we're about to leave. That's what's going on. It's time to go because it's late. I got kids. You're leaving? I just got here. I know. You gotta understand, us old people need to get to bed eventually, so can't be staying up all night.
You're so old, you slacker.
I know. Your favorite, I know, left on the favorite part of just inking. Yay, inking.
He's saving it for Sunday.
Oh, inking. You love it. Yeah, no, no. But on Sunday, I will be inking a lot because we're already on that page. So, you know, so that's something, right?
No.
No, it's nothing. But, yeah, so we're... It's time for us to go so I can get up with my kids.
Yeah, old man.
Yep. But thank you all so much for coming to hang out. It's been fun. What? I don't stay up late. I'm just on San Diego time. That's fair. But yeah, so thank you all for coming and hanging out on the first stream of the year. We're going to be doing apparently a lot more because we're knocking out these pages. So thanks for hanging out. Thanks for the support. Thanks for the subs. You guys are awesome. And yeah, if you are not following McAG, definitely go over and follow his channel. He's got a lot of good content. So definitely go and check him out. But have a good night. And I hope to see you on Sunday. And as always, remember, born a ninja, die a ninja. I will see you all on Sunday. See you later.
The Ninja Empire is supreme, dominant, and unstoppable. Our ninja spirit is fueled by fire and driven by razor-sharp determination. When we take on a mission, we must succeed or die. Our style is unique and deadly, and no one wants to suffer the wrath of the Ninja Empire.